Serotonin is a hormonal substance that's natural, normal in the body. It serves various functions. In the brain, it acts particularly as a neurotransmitter. It helps the many different functions in the brain. But in the rest of the body, though it may have some neurologic function, it acts mainly to help regulate and facilitate the contractions of the smooth muscle in the intestinal tract, and is germane or important for bowel function. No, while there is in general a relationship to the severity of the carcinoid syndrome and the level of serotonin, there's no direct correlation. There are other substances that are produced by the tumor, such as bradykinin and chromogranin, substance P, and neurokinin A, just to name the most common ones, and they don't all cause diarrhea. Well, the main ones are bananas, pineapple juice, plums, eggplant, nuts, and a few other things. Tomato juice. These are the main things that need to be avoided. But more details are available through the Carcinoid Cancer Foundation online.
What is the range of time for how long a particular food will affect serotonin level?
That's an interesting question. That depends to some degree upon how long your digestive system has to take. Some people digest rapidly, other people less. But by and large, the foods that are high in serotonin and alter the blood levels, which are important for measuring, should be avoided for at least 24 hours before the test. One usually measures serotonin in the blood, and the urine test is usually of its end metabolic product, 5-hydroxyindoleacetic acid, abbreviated as 5-HIAA. That's usually measured as a 24-hour urine collection. However, that's not a convenient test to do all the time. We can do a blood serum test of 5-HIAA, and that's helpful. They're both useful tests, either the blood or the serotonin or 5-HIAA or the urine test. That would be unusual, but there isn't always a very direct and exact correlation between the values. It's more common, although it's not frequent, to have a high blood serotonin and only a modestly elevated 5-HIAA in the urine. And there are many reasons for that. Yes, of course. Well, the well-known way of doing it is to give a somatostatin analog medication, namely sandostatin or octreotide or lanreotide, which is somatuline. These drugs inhibit or block the receptors, and so the blood serotonin levels fall